Hello everyone, welcome to Skills Build Training YouTube channel. Myself Muhammad Zubair, and this channel is all about showing you how to become an IT pro really fast. So the topic of today's video is best 5 free video editing softwares. So without any further ado, let's get started. So in today's video, I'll be talking about some of the most advanced tools which are used by professionals, but they are free, and at the same time, I'll be talking about some of the other tools which are used by beginners. Number one is Blender. When we talk about this particular software, most of the people have thoughts of 3D animations making about it. Yes, it is a powerful 3D animation making tool and 3D modeling tool, but this tool does not stop here. It gets also used for the video editing. Its built-in video editor feature never lags behind other video editors. Originally, it was started as the 2D animation tool, which soon got the attention of the people and got very popular. If we talk about its compatibility, it is compatible for Windows, macOS and Linux as well. Let's talk about some of its video editing features. It has all the functions which any other video editor have. We can easily delete, paste the strips, and we can snap and slip the strips as well. It also has the features like color grading, texting and filtering. We get audio and video track separately in it. It also allows us to add other audio files and mix it with the video file. We can speed up and slow down a video as well. Good thing about this tool is we can preview the video while editing. And because of proxy render and frame offset, which are the features, this video editing tool fails very seldom. It is getting used and performing at the same level of HitFilms Express, which is used for modeling, animation and rendering for many movies. For example, Hardcore Henry, Jurassic World and an animation movie Next Gen are among the list of movies which proves its powerful functionalities. So it means many professionals are using this tool for giant projects as well. So at the last, I would say it is the most advanced tool, and if I say it is for the professionals, that would not be wrong. So if I conclude this, I would say this professional tool has all the features which one ideal video editing tool must have. But as I said, this is for the professionals. If you are a beginner, you must not go with it. But if you are really planning to have a career in video editing tool, this must be in your list when you get into your professional life. And now let's move ahead. The second video editing tool which I'm going to talk about is DaVinci Resolve. If we talk about this particular tool, although it is a free one, but as per its functionalities and the features which it provides, it is among the list of tools which are industry renowned and are paid ones, like Adobe Premiere Pro and Apple's Final Cut. Strange thing is, these two have a very heavy price tag, and still they do not offer a lot of post-production solution at a one place. But DaVinci does. And as DaVinci has a lot of post-production solutions, that is why it is used by many productions like Avengers and Hunger Games, etc. So same as Blender, this is also a professional tool. Now let's talk about some of its features. DaVinci offers hundreds of advanced audio tools, and as it has a very good design, so it is very easy for the users to understand. As I have told you that it's a free tool, but it does not mean it lags in performance. Color grading is one of its prominent features, and new tool has been added to it, like HDR grading, color wrapper, and the magic mask. In this tool, working with the effects is more easier and more user-friendly. And by just hovering over an effect, It will show you its application, which means we can see it before applying it on our videos. Targeted grading is one of the brilliant features which allows us to select a specific section from the video and color correct it. And that shows the depth of feature that we can color correct a part of a video as well. And it shows the power of this tool. The very prominent feature of DaVinci Resolve is multicam editing. It means it allows us to edit footage from the multiple cameras at a time. We can edit the footage of more than 16 cameras at the same time in it. The last feature which I'm going to talk about is multi-user collaboration. In this tool, the post-production process has a linear workflow, which means each department adds their work and they pass it on to the next department. In conclusion, I would say it is one of the advanced tools and it is for the professionals. Its learning is also quite big, which means we again have to spend good amount of time to learn this tool. Just like Blender, it is an open source tool and it has a very big community. Now, the third one is Windows Movie Maker. Now, this tool is for the beginners. So this is the interface of Windows Movie Maker. We can import and we can organize the data in various format. We can import the data in AVI, MP3, MP4, MPG, WAV, and MOV format, etc. Just click on this which says files, and from here you can click on new project. And what it will do, it will create a new project, and in that you will be able to do your video editing. And here we have a big plus sign. If I click on it, it will allow us to import different format files in this tool. So I will just close this one. The very cool feature about this tool is the titles. This allows us to choose any fonts from the system and add into our videos just like any other good video editing software. So here we have different features, or you can say different major features, which this tool provides. Here you have music category. So what you can do, you can use this repository of music, which is by default available in this tool, into your videos. And then in text, we can have these sort of text into our videos. And then we have transition, like we have bar, blind one line, and if you scroll down, you have a whole list of transitions which you can apply in this tool. And then we have effects, and these are the effects which you can apply on your videos or on the pictures of which you have added into your video. And at the last, we have element, and in that we will have more features. And here you can see we have a lot of other features. Now if we go back into my media, here you can see it says sample colors, sample videos. So what it means, these are the sample colors which are available in it by default. And if you want to see some sample videos, here these are. You can click on any one of these and you can have an idea that how it works. This is the preview window. Here you will see your video on which you are working. And these are the strips, or you can say these are the tracks where you will add your videos, your different audios, and here you will add your different images, and then you will apply these different features on your video. So that was all about Windows Movie Maker. So at the end, I would say if you are a beginner, you must give it a try. The next tool which I'm going to talk about is iMovie. This is one another very powerful tool which is really good for the professionals, but especially for the beginners. This tool is available for the Mac operating system. This video editing software has not changed a lot till now, but still it is much better than what we get in Windows 10. Its interface is really simple and we only see the needed tools on the interface, which means it do not clutter the screen with all the tools so that user can use only those ones which he needs at the moment. We have three video editing pans in it, with preview of the video on the top right, timeline spanning at the bottom of the screen, and content on the top left. The problem with this tool is we only get two video tracks, which is drawback, as several other applications allows you to add 100 plus track at one moment. Editing is really easy in this tool, as every step is self-explanatory and user-friendly. This tool offers the special effects which we can add to our videos, and along with that we can add freeze time. Freeze time is a feature in which we can freeze a frame, add speed or slow down a frame. The iMovie editor works with the iTunes and GarageBand for the background music purpose, and we have decent selection of background and sound effects and soundtracks. And once we are done with all the editing, we can share our completed work on different platforms like iTunes, Vimeo and YouTube, and we can use iMovie on the iOS devices as well. And that's a really cool thing, as it allows the user to feel free about the choice of hardware device. So at the end, I would say that this tool is very good for the personal task, and it is free. Anyone can use that tool, but if you want to use this for professional reasons, that might not be a good choice, because there are some very good tools for that purpose, like I have just talked about at the start of this video, Blender and DaVinci. The last one which I'm going to talk about is Movavi Video Editor. This tool is around from 2004 and it is being used by over 300 million users across the globe. It offers a lot of features and you can edit your videos very easily in that tool. Just like any other tool, we can add our video in it, cut it, put some transitions, effects, add music, add filters and much more. This tool aims to make video editing as easy as possible. Now, if you talk about the layout and some features of it, as you can see on your screen, its layout is really standard one and really simple one, just like any other video editing software. When we were talking about Windows Video Editor, it had the almost same interface just like this one. Now, if you talk about its feature, here you can see we have color adjustment, then we have crop and rotate, then we can overlay our video frame, and then we have animation, stabilization and different other features. Here if I click on this one, this is all about the filters, which means we can apply these filters onto our videos, and we have these options in terms of our filters. So if I go into blur section, here you can see these are the filters in terms of blur. Now let's move ahead, and these are the transitions which we can apply, or you can say which we can use into our videos. And then we have our titles, and this is how you can add different types of title at the start, or you can say at the end of your videos. The next one is stickers. If you click on it, these are different stickers which you can apply into your videos. And the last one is all tools. In here you can have different things which you can do in terms of your videos. Now the most important one is this one, which is media files. In that you can have these type of media files which you can use for video editing. And here we have different sections. If I go into sounds, these are the sounds which you can add into your videos, and they are available here by default. Like we have applause, it will add an applause sound into your video. And then we have beep, then we have breaking glass and different other sound effects. In music, we have this repository of music which is available here. You can download your own one, or you can add your own one here. Then we have sample videos, just like Windows Video Editor. And then we have different backgrounds which we can use. And then we have effect packages. So these are those features which are really important for any video editing software or tool, and fortunately we have all these available in this tool as well. So at the end, I would say if you are a beginner, you must try this tool as well. So if you are planning to use any professional tool like Blender or DaVinci Resolve, before that you must use this one, so that you can have an idea that how to work with different video formats and how to add different effects, transition, and how to get the best out of your video. And that brings us to the end of today's video. I hope you have learned and you have enjoyed this video. Please leave a like and subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon as well. And if you have something to ask, please leave a comment below. We will get back to you as soon as possible. Until the next video, take care.